Welcome back to Barn Build Peters. In this episode, we are building body mounts for this bed so we can mount it to our new frame. If you haven't seen my previous videos, we have a 2018 Dodge Ram frame that we're throwing the old Ford body on top. So of course, since the body is not a Dodge, nothing lines up. So we have to customize everything. Now, I've already done a little tiny bit of this process. I always like to do one half or one side of a project and then bring you guys in along for the other side, but I'm kind of at an important step, so I'll show you what that is and you can follow along with the rest of the project. What I've already done off camera is I leveled the bed to the frame, so the bed floor is roughly parallel to the frame rails. This way, we can make body mounts and keep everything in a line. So now that I have that, I want to be able to find that point very easy. So we're going to focus on making these front body mounts first. That way, when you set it down, it's level again as the back half sits on the frame rail. We have our piece of scrap steel here, but we need it to sit on top of the frame rails. So what I've done is I found the curve and cut it out. So this part will sit nicely onto the frame rail and we can weld it right to the frame. You might be wondering how I got that to fit as nicely as it does, and that's with this gauge finder. What this does is it matches the contour of any shape that you put it on. So right now, it's all blocked out, it's in a square, but when you press down like onto this irregular piece of metal, it will find the shape, and there's your shape, and then you can just transfer that onto your piece of scrap steel and cut it out to make your body mount or whatever piece you're making. Now that we have this cut out, this follows the curvature of the frame rails, so it provides a nice tight fit for when we weld. Now we can focus on transferring our design for the body mount onto this new steel, which is the other side's body mount for the front of the bed. So we'll take a Sharpie with everything lined up and trace the pattern. Now we can cut this out on the bandsaw and start making our other side's body mount. As you can see from the completed body mount, this piece that we cut out is a little bit taller than the actual body mount needs to be. So we brought it over here to adjust the height. So how are we going to do that? There's a steel plate that is resting on top. So I have to account for that when I mark my height. So what I'm going to do is crawl underneath the truck. I'm going to take this eighth inch piece of metal here, place it underneath this cross member up against the upright, and then scribe a line underneath, and that will resemble where I need to cut, and it factors in this top plate as well. Well, that side didn't work quite as nicely, but we did get a mark, and I can use my speed square, trace that line, cut off this section, and run around for test fit. Now with it nice and cut, we can do a test fit. And that is pretty nice and snug. So that works out perfect and we can cut the other side. We got our body mounts just placed in here, and right now the full weight of the bed is on the body mounts and it's supporting itself. We're back out in the shop and we have our body mounts fully made and just tacked into place on the frame. So it's finally time to test fit the bed one last time prior to fully welding these up. If everything looks good, which I'm really hoping it does, we'll take the bed off, fully weld them, and we can drill some holes to actually mount the bed. So we got the bed over here and I crawled underneath, I checked all the body mounts and we did find one that does need to be adjusted. That's exactly why you test fit stuff prior to actually welding it fully in. So we'll pull the bed back off, which we had to do anyways, set it over on the old truck and then adjust the one body mount and final weld everything up. All right, this body mount here was the culprit and we just have to grind off the tack welds and readjust it. So we got our grinder, we got our hammer, and we'll get this body mount off and tacked in no time. We got the body mount ground off and now we have it adjusted and being held up by magnets. I've leveled it and put it in the correct spot. So now I'm going to tack it into place. And then once it's tacked, I'm going to remove the magnets and fully weld it back into place without test fitting it, as I'm pretty confident this is where it's supposed to go. Once we're done welding this, we'll just move on to all the other body mounts and weld those in as well. We have the bed back onto the frame and I've taken the time to square up everything, both front and back, so everything should be aligned up within about a 16th of an inch. And now it's time to mark the body mounts so we can drill them. So I have a center punch here and a hammer. We're gonna crawl up there, put the center punch through the bolt holes and hit it and mark our location, where we will then take the bed back off, set it somewhere safe, and drill those holes out for our bolts. Now with the bed off, I was able to check our center punch marks and make sure that they actually do make sense. It's kind of hard to be perfectly straight, so they do check out good. I did correct a couple of them. And then now we've used some PB Blaster as our lubricant for our drill, and we're just going to start off small and step up drill bits until we get to the proper size. Now, one last time, we can get the bed back over here, test fit the bolt holes, and make sure that everything lines up as it should. Hopefully, there's enough slop that if I messed up a little bit, we can still get that bolt through there and everything lines up good. Well, we got the bed back onto the frame and the bolt holes do line up. There's 5 bolts in the bolt holes right now. They're not tightened down since we're probably gonna have to remove this again anyways, so there's really no point. I only have 5 bolts, so I only tested 5 locations and they all line up. So I would bet the other 3 would as well. So if you guys like this video, be sure to like, comment, and don't forget to hit that subscribe button so you don't miss my future content, and I'll catch you in the next one.